Hi, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I'm going to show you how to use MidJourney for beginners. So if you've never heard of MidJourney before, what it is, you're able to write in a prompt, so describe something, and hit enter, and it's going to give you back images. So this is done from text to images by AI here. So MidJourney makes it pretty simple to do this. And it's just more than just images too. So you could use this to create logos. You could create posters with this. You could create website mockups. There's really an endless amount of things. You're going to be limited by your imagination of what you can create. And you can see as I scroll through this, all of everybody's imagination taken from text and put into all these images. So today on Teachers Tech, I want to show you the 7 steps to get started with MidJourney so you can start taking your text and putting it into images. So step one, if you've never used MidJourney before and you don't have an account, you need to create an account. And to do this, where you need to go is midjourney.com. I'll put the link down below in the description so you can click on it and get to the page where I am. You're going to need to join the beta here. So we're going to click on join the beta because you need to join the Discord on it. So I'm going to go ahead and just hit continue to Discord right here. You are going to need to make an account. Now I already have an account, but you're going to need to register for a Discord account. You can see on this one, I can go ahead and register here, and I can also scan with Discord mobile app to log in instantly this way. So if you don't have an account, make sure you hit pause, go and register, and then we'll get signed in. So I'm just using the free account for MidJourney, which allows me 25 images. You can pay for subscriptions and get more if you want to do it that way, but I've just been using the free one. Now I'm logged into Discord. You probably got some emails, or when you logged in, there'd be some invitations. If you don't see MidJourney right here, so this is going to be the server that we want to make sure we're part of, and we have this here. If you don't see that, you can go ahead and add the server. We could hit join a server. If there was an invitation link they sent you, if you don't have an invite, you can see how you go through and look, and you can search MidJourney's right at the top here, and then you can kind of go through this way. But we need to make sure we have MidJourney as one of the servers that we're part of here. So make sure you accept the invites also that you get, or else you're not going to get all the functions of even being inside here. So now we've got our Discord service, we're part of it, we're inside MidJourney here. What's the next step? So step two is you need to find a newbies channel. So here I have them right here. So I have a few different ones. I'll just select this one right here that I'm already in. These won't show up unless you've accepted the terms of service. So you'll probably see something if your first time logging in, a TOS, and you have to make sure you accept it to see these rooms. So now let's move on to step three, and that's going to be just to use the imagine command. So where do we put this? So down at the very bottom, we just click in this where we're going to add the prompt, and we're just going to do /, and we're going to start typing imagine. And even as I start typing it, you can see that I could just click on this. I don't even have to type the whole thing. So I'll just click on it. This is where my prompt is. Now I'm going to just write something that I want. So I'm going to go ahead and just write a bunny playing a flaming saxophone. So something random, just like this. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit enter. Now, this is where it can get a little confusing sometimes, is trying to find where your image will be. And what you need to do is just keep scrolling down, and you'll see it. It's kind of in a queue. So there's an order of how busy it's going to be with MidJourney here. And it's going to be waiting to get created. So you do have to just kind of scroll down towards the bottom and wait for yours to appear. And this can take, sometimes it's quick, and depending on how busy the server is, and other times it can take a bit and can be a little confusing to find. So let's go ahead and just wait for it. And I can see right there, that was pretty quick. I have these different images right here. And notice that when mine comes up, it has this yellow line to help kind of identify of it. So now what's the next step I can do? You can see I can click on this and I get four different images right here. But now I can kind of select one of those and upscale them. So before I move on to the next step, I just want to point out the community guidelines here because I think it's important that everybody knows and follow here. I'm not going to read through them, but I will post this as a link down below so you can check this out and making sure that you stay in the parameters of the community guidelines. Step number five, and notice it seems like if I've skipped one, it's because step number four was actually the processing to get to this. Step number five allows me to choose one of these and upscale it, or choose one of them and make a slight variation. So you can see right here we have V. So this would be a variation to number one, variation to number two, variation to number three or four. So that's how they're numbered. Now, if I just want to go ahead and if I like one of these, I can go ahead and choose. So maybe I like number two here. I could select U2 and notice how it turns blue. And then I can go ahead and refresh it and it's going to create an upscale of that one that I've chosen. So just go ahead and choose that. And then it will be in the queue again to get created. And we'll just wait for that and let's see the finished result. So now I scroll down a little bit again, and you can see here is the one that I created and I upscaled it. I can make variations again on this. So this creates a variation of the upscaled image and generates a new grid of four options. I can do an upscale redo here and also the beta one, or I could bring it to the web and we have some places where we can rate it right here with these different emojis. But let's say if we like our finished one, we want to go ahead and open it up. What I usually do is I just click on it and you get the larger upscale one, but you can open it up again in browser. So if I open it up here, now this is where I can just right click on this and save this as an image. So if I go ahead and save this as an image, I can save it to my other ones. I could rename it, hit save, and it saves down to my computer and I can use it how I wish at that point. And then if I go back over to the server, if I just click off of this again, you can see where if I wanted to make those variations. Now, something I want to point out is that I usually use the Discord server on my computer. So if you don't have it installed, you can download the app. I find it works a little bit better than using it online how I've been doing. So I would suggest download the app, log in. And as I said, it just works a little bit better. I'm using the free one here also. So if you're looking at creating lots of images, go ahead. The other thing I would point out is start reading other people's to see the description that they're putting into these to learn of what you can write and how you can learn. Because you can use things like even with camera, with lighting, types of lenses. And the more you learn the language of how to be descriptive when you write, the better the images will be. So I hope you like this intro on how to use MidJourney, how to create these graphics using AI just from simple text. Let me know if you use this when you do use it. Just let me know down in the comments. And if you're looking for other AI, I'll put a link to my ChatGPT video too, where I give examples of some great ways that you can use it. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.